all know that today there is an unprecedented attack on Indian democracy, on our constitutional rights and our constitutional values. We can look at any aspect of the constitution and democracy, and we see that there is an attack. Even if you talk about the electoral process, we see how it has been vitiated. The electoral bonds that were brought in by the current government have been nothing but a way of ensuring that the ruling party keeps getting unlimited amount of anonymous money and keeps filling its coffers. And in a sense, it's something the electoral bonds really make the process of elections, they render it useless. Because on the one hand, we know that money power is playing such a huge role in doing elections in the country, controlling the electoral process. And then finally, even after elections, the way we are seeing the trading of MLAs, of elected representatives, it's all an influence of money power, which is totally eroding the very basis of our electoral democracy. The other big issue that the country is facing is how institutions like the parliament have been totally compromised. We are seeing that it has become a game of numbers. The kind of laws that have been brought in, which are anti-people laws, janta virodhi kanoon jo laye ja rahe hain, whether it is the CAA, the Citizenship Amendment Act, or it is the abrogation of Article 370, whether it is the transgender law that is being pushed, we are seeing that consistently anti-people laws are being pushed in the parliament by brute majority. And this is something that we need to raise our voice against. We are also seeing an unbridled increase in the power of crony capitalism. We are seeing how very few people in our country are controlling all the resources. The kind of economic policies that are being followed, that are being pushed by the current government, are just enhancing inequality, enhancing poverty. They are working basically for a few people in our country.
Modi government is using the pandemic and the lockdowns and is thinking that the people are not in a position to revolt or to raise any kind of voice, that they are trying to change the entire nature of this country. The question today is, there's going to be a hunger pandemic in the country very soon. It's already started. The unemployment situation we all are aware of, the health situation, now the education situation, the violence issues. Now, these are the issues which is actually the duty of a government to respond to. But this government, the Modi government, is going ahead with its agenda of not only the neoliberal policies, which it is already, but at the same time trying to change the secular democratic character of our nation. And it is changing the laws. It is having rushing through laws by undemocratically setting up committees and giving such short time spans that nobody can respond to. Be it the environment impact assessment law, or the changes in the criminal laws, or the new education policy, or any of these aspects. If you see, the parliament is not working, no discussions are being implemented, are being encouraged. Secondly, the entire judicial system also today is in such a situation where we are finding that was supposed to be our last resort, but that is also becoming too far from the concept of justice. Now, keeping all this in mind, we have to show the government that there may be a pandemic, there is a pandemic, there is a lockdown, but the people of this country are alive and kicking. Yeah, cantante, vamos a triunfar, avanz.